66 for 6.
Had to have it, didn't they, the Devils? Just had to. Karen KC in at number 8. Here, yeah, because Alex Davies was rather ambitious with lack of footwork to the max. Lewis is still upset here. Oh well.
Yeah, just went. Pune Devils, that run rate was excellent at the start. We are well rolled. Excellent delivery. Good over. 66 for 6.
Six after 6. And it's a bit like that, really, after a birthday and a half. And it's only just getting started. Well, we love it here in the UAE. Abu Dhabi with season 4 of the Alubon Tea Time. Here is Rad Emmett. And there's Hardison Yu. He's not playing. On the ball, he was telling me prior to the coin toss, he landed on there on his IT band, landed heavily on it in the field, and that's why he says, oh, like I had a corked thigh and he's not inside.
Yeah, it's never a nice feeling, and that ITB is normally tight anyway. As athletes, you see those foam rollers in the S&C kind of kit, and they pull them out and almost self-massage.
There's that bounce. This is what happens here in the evening. A particular third match, now that it's flipped over 9 o'clock local time. Hardison Ewan was saying this too. He said, very frustrating that he's not playing in this. And they tended to play more day games, the Devils. And he was saying, this, he reckons, is probably one of the quicker pitches of the main part of the square, the central part of this pitch area. And he said, he's a bit miffed that he's injured. He'd love to have had another go here. And that puts it up to 22 yards.
Yeah, well, certainly the Northern Warriors, they're used to playing the night game. There's Ken R. Lewis. Still going, still discussing. I like his watch, by the way. This is the dismissal. Yeah, he doesn't think he's hit it. What? I'm out. Seriously? Rubbish.
Up and over the skipper. Is it safe? Yeah. Luckily, just enough wood on it. And Simmons couldn't get there. Yeah. And I was just, well, pop under the stands, going to have a net. Just bent a bit of spleen and get in the nets. Jonty was saying, well, we'll come for a run with me then. We'll go for a quick little 10 pounds. Ain't happening. Sorry, coach. Curran. Bold. Red and red.
the stage that they're at, the projected score going at 10 runs and over, they just get to 100. You get a sense with these two, they just don't feel comfortable with pace on, do they? Pace on and back of a length. They seem to be jumping around a fair bit.
And the wide length side, just a little too short here. The idea was right, just not quite with the execution.
You could almost expect that, couldn't you? After seeing them hopping and skipping in the popping crease. So wouldn't be surprised if they go a little bit shorter, ribs, that type of thing, and then try to set the batter up and then go full Yorker length to try and knock them over.
The other one. Nice change up. Seven done. 70 for six here. Pune Devils, they were asked to bat first by Nicholas Porang. It's not gone great, as just been said. Captain, with the gloves and pads on, he's just having a look around, just having a look at the field. Yeah, more zip. Almost on cue, almost all of them. Just one on the far right, they're just a little flutter. Yeah, they're all subtly different, aren't they? Just it's amazing. After 9 p.m., the breeze just subsides, dies away.
Yeah, and then the dew sets in, doesn't it? So the second innings, the ball starts to skid on nicely. Shot. Well, Hussain now thinking, right, I've got to dance down the wicket and generate a bit of pace going in front of the wicket.
Well, let's get it on as well. And off the blade. Oh, yeah, very flamboyant through the offside. The captain, Nasser Hussain. Thanks very much.
First boundary after three overs, desperately needed by the Pune Devils.
Yep, let's follow the ball because that man has gone right there, extra cover on the fence. Try something a little tricky here, as we're saying. Not much happening.
No, not much happens when it's that length, is it? Both Curran and Hussain just aren't quite sure what to do. How to play it. Hello, drone. We have gotten some beautiful shots from that, especially as the sun was setting. I'm surprised, given that it's your birthday, Danny, why you weren't up there kind of navigating it. Bit of fun.
It was. Where are you?
Oh.
You're sleeping again, right? Come on. What are the Warriors on the program status? Fired up. This is the Super League stage of season four. Yeah, and the Devils, they're on their way out. Partake much more of T10 here in January 2021. Exciting though, because end of the year, this will be back in its normal slot of November. Here in Abu Dhabi, nice in November, we'll be back here for another bit of TT. Of course, it was supposed to be last November, but of course with the pandemic and the IPL kind of these shores, changed it up. Oh, hello and goodbye. Wow, is right. What a strike.
Oh, could he be the Dream 11 game changer just to get them over that three-figure mark? They need it. They need something for their bowlers to bowl to. Nice strike. Came out of nowhere.
But it came out of the middle enough. Oh, yes. What a cracker. Bowler Junaid Siddiqui, he knows. Shows a little clip there too. Parnell having a chat with Poran. Yeah, just sussing strategy, tweaking the fields. Start to branch out here, and the confidence is flowing from the skipper. 13 off the 8, that's 83 for 6 now. Saying, nice ball. What have we got here, Lisa?
Yeah, a little bit of chat. I think that both these teams aren't playing. The win means something. You can see that. There's egos, there's performances, there's reselection in this competition, as you were saying, this November.
I hope from Siddiqui it wasn't in English. He's got right over the head of Nasser Sain. Oh, gorgeous. Hello.
Just within two balls, we've seen two different emotions.
Two different fielders too, swapping and moving. We've got Mohammad Wasim on the boundary. Cross-batted. It's good because he's done the right thing and given the strike back to the skipper, Nasser Sain. Good stuff from Alan KC.
He's taken a leaf out of his skipper's book by dancing down the pitch. Try and create some power, some momentum, because at the moment for them standing still and trying to hit hasn't necessarily worked.
That's quick and zippy, but it's just a little too short, says Alex Wharf to his good mate Ramon Martinez, and there's the one for the over as well. Really zip through here. Too short. And Parnell.
He's not a tall man, is he? Is he Hussain? So he's going to go around the stumps. Just change the angle slightly. Field hasn't changed at all.
It's almost a new way, telegraph. With that protection on the leg side, he could try and cramp up Nasser Hussain. He was waiting. Half the over gone. Throw the wide in there. And, let's see what else they can do. 12s from here. I know we've only got an over and a half. Can they get past 100? It's a tough gig for the Devils. Zingers are alight, and we've got number 7 at that lovely number for Lisa Stalaker, the Aussie.
Yeah, it strikes, doesn't it? Comes around the wicket, cuts down the angle, hits the top of off. Good catch by Nicholas Puran as well behind the stumps. Yeah, Wayne Parnell again in the wickets. He's picked up 3 wickets. They're just going to check the back foot, no ball. This is the problem with left-handers when they come around the wicket. Sometimes they get close. No, fine. He's well inside. Yeah, he's actually got plenty of room to go if he wants. So, Curran. He's the last batter out. And he goes for three. It's the Devils are 87 for seven.
KC, it's Curran KC. Bernie Devils, yeah, five down, only 34 on the board. Deliveries left. Oh, there it is! What a ripper! Talk about a power going wrong for the batting side. Dream 11 game changer, you better believe it. Three wickets in this over so far and not a run in it.
Well, the floating power play taken by the Devils. Absolute nightmare scenes for the batting side. But Ali Khan, bandaged up, battered and bloodied. He's taken three in the over. Curran's gone for a first ball. 34 for six.